What do you want?
How you been?
I'm fine. What do you want?
Nothing. I just want hello.
Okay.
Okay. You want to do lunch one day?
Not really.
Oh, man, you're breaking my heart.
No.
No, I tell you what happened, Jenny. I got cold cock because the lawyer called. I was like, I told Jenny I did not want to be part of this. So I got angry at you. I'm gonna let you know. But I see that, you know, it was something that I probably should have maybe talked to the lawyer about. But I just, at that time, I did not want to get involved with it. I still don't, to be honest. But, so that's why. Letting the cat out of the bag because that's how I was feeling at that time. And I didn't, I saw that she had called, but I didn't want to get involved with that shit. And, but, so, that's where, when I, Mary contacted me and Jackson and said, can you go pick up the laptop? I said, oh, equipment. You didn't say equipment. But Jackson ended up doing it because I didn't want to talk. So he drove all the way south side. He wanted to where is that? Glen Allen somewhere. I didn't want to do it there. So anyway, he picked it up. So still with me?
No, I don't.
Oh man.
No, you guys really even Jackson.
What happened?
Nobody visited Jackson once at the hospital. That was it.
To what? I'm sorry?
I said, no one visited Jackson, and I was there. And he said that he never saw that they treated me very well while I was at Wells Fargo. And I'm like, really, fucking Jackson? Really?
To what? I'm sorry. I don't know anything about this. What are you talking about?
They called Jackson.
Yeah?
And he said... that they treated me well while I was there.
Oh, well, I don't know any about that.
Yeah, well, it's just a fucking point. I'm just saying. I'm just telling you. I know you don't know anything about it because you don't know what he said. But I'm just saying that I was there to visit Jackson at the fucking hospital. I was there for him. I was his friend. And he couldn't tell the truth. The fuck? I'm like, shit, man. Fucking be a friend. You knew what the fuck I was going through. You saw what happened. You spoke to Larry on the fucking phone when we were in the call and you told him how you felt.
I know. And I told you, I told you I was involved with it. I mean, not involved, but I told you I was there when he said it, or...
Echo, stop.
Huh?
Echo?
Echo? What echo?
I want to see what the front door.
Yeah, I was in that meeting when Paul said it. I know how shitty of a manager Larry is.
We were all there, but not just that. You complained when we came into the fucking team.
Oh, I know, and I know that, and I tell you. But when the lawyer, but I also told you I didn't want to be involved in it, and that's why I didn't say anything. And I told the attorney general that, you know, I'm not participating in this, and she left it as it was. I didn't say they were guilty, or I didn't say that, you know, they were innocent. I just said I did not want to be part of this. And they left me alone. But I did not say anything to discount what, you know, what they did to you, either. And like I said, I should have maybe said something, but at that time I was, didn't want to really have them put the pain.
You're helping them get away with the fucking shit that they're doing, that's all. And they're going to do it to somebody else, and maybe you, or maybe Jackson, because the asshole that they got in as a supervisor, he's a fucking racist, too.
I'm sure of that.
They said they didn't want to fit, because all the work we had, that taking me out of the team would hurt the team. I'm like, what the fuck? They split our team. They weren't downsizing Larry's team. They downsized our team. They split our team up. They didn't split up fucking Larry's team. Larry's team wasn't impacted at all. Bullshit.
Well, they made it seem that way because they ended up, whether it's through the fault, either Larry did it, or maybe from some people higher up, they ended up, you know, breaking up his team, but not to the degree of ours. You know, it's, what is it? Christelle, Stacy, Sean Miller, you know, the bunch of them. I mean, not a bunch of them, but, you know, Schneider.
Yeah, but that wasn't...
That was after the fact.
No, that was before we even got there.
Exactly. Well, no, that was after you were already on leave.
Stacy wasn't there when that was before they split up our team. That was when I was already on Larry's team.
You were on Larry's team at that time, but it wasn't official then until it was official.
It was. Stacy wasn't on that team anymore.
Oh, okay. I didn't keep up with it. I just know that the announcement that there was, so-and-so on the internet.
No, they were already on. They weren't part of that team. Stacy and what's his name were on another team already. What's his name? Scott.
Scott Lee?
Scott Cummings.
Oh, Scott Cummings. Oh, yeah. Oh, they were already out.
Yeah, no. They split us and put us in different things. They just had us with Larry. Larry had a 17 people team.
Yeah, no, I thought that they had busted out after that. They subdivided them even more.
No, Larry had 17, and then they split up all the work that we did.
Yeah.
All the work that we did, they took it all away.
Yeah.
And they distributed everything. And they just they just wanted us to do the fucking grunt work. That's all it was. They gave all of our shit away. Security.
They did. In hindsight, I don't know if anything, we could have prevented anything anyway. That dude was in place, and he was there, to wreck us, and he wrecked us. But the only thing that we could have possibly done to make the transition easier was to conform to what the fuck he's saying. But still, me, I'm still kicking and screaming that I don't want to give up my shit, but they're making us now, just yesterday, we're giving them check printer access, the rest of the Larry's team, or, a handful of them, giving them check printer access, we're giving them mainframe access. That was just announced yesterday. So, if whatever they want, they're going to kiss, essentially, is what's happening. I don't know, Jenny, it's just, I still think of you, and I don't still think of you as a very good friend. I just at that time didn't want to be part of the suit, and I got angry about that. But I didn't do anything to say that they were innocent or guilty. I just left it that I didn't want to participate, and it didn't bother me. But I still want to take you out to lunch. if you, when you're ready. But I'm getting my hair done. So next time you see me, I won't look like a scrub. I'm driving to get a haircut. Not that you care, but.
Kid, I'm disassociating with everybody. I can't deal with anybody. Then. I can't deal with
anybody. I totally understand. And, you know, when you're ready.
I don't think I'll ever be ready. I'm so hurt. I'm extremely hurt because I wouldn't do that to anybody I consider a friend. All I ask would be that to tell the truth. And you saw how they did me.
Yeah, you know, a lot of, some people react differently than others. I didn't want to jeopardize. You know how when they got that bead on you, Larry, they kept on poking you and jabbing you. And I was, you know, I was frankly worried about that would happen to me as well. And I wasn't ready for it.
My dad's death took a toll on me. And you guys handle. I'm older than you are. And I had a good ride while I was there, and I was just waiting for the time.
And every day, I pray for myself to get. You hit that lottery and retire away from this crap, too. I really do. Bob and I still chat. And, you know, I'm still here grinding, and I'm hoping that there's a few years left that they'll give us me. Because that shit, it could happen any day. And, I don't know. It, what they did was a witch hunt. And, you know, I'm just. I can't apologize for something at that time I felt was right for me and my family. And when they came at me, you know, I talked to her with Steph, and she was like, man, you gotta make sure that you still have a job. So we talked about it. And there was nothing to discount what they did to you. What they did to you. But at that time, it was like about me. I didn't tell them a lie. I didn't do anything. But I just didn't have your back. And that was what I'm kind of guilty of. I didn't have your back. That it was about me and my family and how they would treat me if I whistled.
I wouldn't do that to my friend. Even if I just wouldn't do that. I wouldn't do that. That's just not who I am. Job or no job. I stand for what I believe in.
Yeah.
That's the difference between me and a lot of people.
That is true.
If I see wrong, I said, I defend my people.
Mm-hmm.
And that's that.
Yep.
I realize that, you know, I'm alone. I'm just alone. And that company is just not fucking worth it.
No, it's definitely not. Definitely
isn't. And they still promoted him, hired a supervisor, they're still doing the same shit. Jim Van Luce is still working there. You know, he kept his job. The other one's still doing his fucking shit as a team lead.
Mm-hmm.
And the world goes round. And he's still gonna go to somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
And there's only two Asians on the team now. Joe DePron retires soon.
Yeah, we got a lot of people taking it. I'm not sure.
Yeah, Well, you have a good life, okay?
All right, you too, Jenny. Take care.